Hello Seekers, welcome to Puneet's Astrology, your one-stop astro channel. First of all, this video is a Vedic astrology video and this is as per sidereal zodiacs. So this is not as per tropical zodiac, so you might feel a difference in my interpretation of planets in a zodiac sign. There is going to be a full moon in the sign of Sagittarius as per Vedic astrology on 24th of June. 24th of June is going to be a very special day, and this is a very special full moon because this full moon is going to happen in the axis of Gemini and Sagittarius, the Mithun and the Dhanu Rashi axis. So what's so special about this? Full moon is a monthly phenomena. It's a very natural thing. Moon completes its cycle and becomes brighter in the sky. But what happens at full moon is the time frame when the chakras are tuned with the cosmos. Moon is man, and full moon is complete light falling on the manah sharir. That means our mind can attain the light of the soul, and mind reflects the maximum light of the soul on a full moon. That is why many rituals in our customs, in our culture, is related to full moon, which is called as Purnima. Now, when moon enters the sign of Sagittarius, it enters the Moola Nakshatra. This will happen on the afternoon of 24th of, in the early morning of 24th of June around 10 a.m. And when moon enters Moola Nakshatra, it finds sun in the Ardra Nakshatra, seventh from itself. Now, see the correlation here. The moon and the sun, which is obviously the axis where the Purnima happens or the new full moon happens, is actually in the Ardra Moola axis or the Ardra Moola galactic plane. Ardra Moola galactic plane is considered to be one of the most chaotic and one of the most transformative galactic plane in the entire axis system that you have in astrology. And this particular nakshatra opposition, when happens, and if two planets fall into this kind of opposition, they are actually in a position to create a transformation that you have never seen before. There can be few planets in your horoscope like this, but if it happens in transit, it impacts every single human being on the planet. So 24th of June becomes a very vital day to extract Amrit and to do a very important task that is pending for a very long time. Also, if you want to create any major transformation in your life, 24th of June is a very, very crucial day. It is a day when you can convert your inauspiciousness to auspiciousness. It is a day when all the tantra forces of the nature are very much active and all the tantra energy reigns supreme, and this creates internalization of power, and this power comes at your hand. If you observe the Karan on that day, it's Vishti Karan. It's a current that is usually considered to be inauspicious, but it's a current which is more tantric in nature. So any siddhi, any mantra jap done on 24th, especially during the night, when moon will be visible in the sky, is going to be of great importance, and the power generated by the mantra chanting will be so high that it will be bound to create transformation in your soul and mind plane. Because it is a sun and moon, it may not create an impact on the physical spectrum, but it will definitely create an impact within you, your personality and your approach towards life. There is another aspect to this particular transit. When moon enters the sign of Sagittarius, moon will travel the Navamsha of Aries. So definitely with the Navamsha of Aries, moon gets a lot of energy. And Mars is with Venus in the sign of Cancer, and if you see, Mars is in Pushya whereas Venus is in Punarvasu. Both are positive nakshatra, especially Mars do fairly well in Pushya nakshatra. So definitely this energy is put to good use, and something interesting is happening here. On a full moon day, Mars and Venus is 8th from moon in the house of moon. Mars is masculine power, Venus is feminine power, it is Purush and Prakriti. And 8th house is defined as something that is secret, something that is internal. something that is not usual. So obviously, the energies are unusual in this time frame. Now, when Moon is finding Mars and Venus 8th from itself, Moon will definitely look to resolve the issue, because initially Moon might feel uneasy and it will want to resolve the issue through 12 and the second house. 12th house, because that's the house where the subconscious mind lies, 12th from Moon. And the second house, where all the resources of the mind lies, that means ideologies, thoughts, tricks, anything that is of value to you, anything that you believe, is second house from Moon. And if Moon finds Saturn and Ketu, 12th is Ketu and 2nd is Saturn. So definitely this is a Pap Kartari Yoga of Moon. So mind will remain blocked. So this 23rd, 24th, 25th and few days here and there, you will feel the energy blocking your mind. Especially if you have Sagittarius Lagna, Sagittarius Moon sign, or any major planet happening to be in Sagittarius in your own horoscope. If you are in Moon Mahadasha or Moon Antardasha, the impact of the full moon will be greatest on you. You will see the major transformation happening through your thought process, and your approach of life will change. Spend your entire day of 24th, if possible, on meditating on your ideologies, meditating on your thought process, and trying to streamline and creating a change. Draft a life path on this particular date that you want to achieve. The goals, goal setting must be done on this day. You want to transform your life, you want to be somebody, you want to change something about you, you want to change something about your surrounding. 24th is the time to manifest that. Now, I'm not saying that 24th is the day when everything will happen all of a sudden, but it can act as a trigger of a chain of events that will alter the timeline of your future. With this kind of power-packed moon, definitely moon cannot say that I am in a comfortable position. Obviously, transformation do not happen comfortably. But if you observe, when moon gets light from the sun, now this is something very crucial, understand this. When moon gets light from the sun, because ultimately moon reflects light of the sun, moon, mana sharir, is nothing but a reflection of your own soul. Sun is aspected by Jupiter. Now see this. Moon gets the light of the sun. Sun is seventh from the moon, in front of the moon. And sun gets light aspect from Jupiter. And Jupiter is in stationary condition. It's in retrograde station. Jupiter just became retrograde on 20th. That means the dispositor of moon, because moon is in the house of Sagittarius, which is ruled by Jupiter. And if the house lord or the Rashi lord itself tries to go retrograde and aspect the soul, and that gets reflected by the moon, that means your mind wants to stop thinking all the nonsense around and wants to focus on internalization and wants to focus on soul realignment, finding ways to know who you really are, knowing within, going within. Just meditate in whatever ways you can. Know yourself. Do something about your ambitions, something that is creative, something that you have been missing in your own life for so many years. This Jupiter, remember, is in Satbhisha Nakshatra, so it is there to heal you. So this is the time for emotional healing. This is the time to correct your mistakes, and this is the time for realization of your own power. Because if Jupiter is the guru, and Jupiter is the Rashi Lord where Moon will be in the day of Purnima, then that Jupiter is already giving its information. Remember, this is the fifth aspect of Jupiter. This is more about wisdom. So the wisdom of Jupiter gets reflected and bounces back from the sun to the moon. So definitely this is the day when information can come, wisdom can come from any sphere of life, from any way, any area, through internet, through a friend. So try to be receptive. And while being receptive, you should be also be aware of your own potential. This is a power-packed day to absorb the potential, to understand what you are and what you can really do. And in a positive sense, not in the negative sense. This is the day when you balance the Purush and Prakriti, the Mars and the Venus, through your own wisdom. This is the day when Rahu and Mercury is in 6th house. It creates out of the box analytical thinking that can give you that one major idea that can pull you out from problems. So use this particular transit for your own benefit. Let's do a quick exercise, and I hope this exercise will help you. What you have to do, I'm going to play a quick music, Tibetan bowl music, and you must sit in what you say as a lotus mudra or Pankaj mudra. This mudra helps you balance the Ida and Pingala, the fire element and the water element in your body. So how you have to do? You have to do the Namaskar position. This mudra balances your entire human body. All the elements touches each element. Now you start spreading the fingers out with your thumb touching the thumb and the small finger touching the small finger, and all other fingers are not touching each other, but they are spread out as if you are trying to receive something. This acts as an antenna, receiver. This mudra or this state is called lotus formation or Pankaj mudra. Now just come near the heart chakra and station your mudra near your heart. Don't touch, just near your heart. Close your eyes. You can sit in the chair, comfortable. Don't pressurize this. Make your body stiff. Just relax. You don't need to push anything. This is not a power struggle. Just relax. Just don't make it like this. Open it up. Now, when I'm opening it up, I will imagine a golden ball inside this, as if I'm holding a ball. So, for example, I'm holding something like this. This is something I'm holding, right? So, imagine that you're holding something, and this, what you're holding is a golden ball, and this ball is of divine light. It's sparkling with happiness. And now you place it near your Anahat Chakra and just close your eyes and do a soft murmur of Om. With every Tibetan bowl, with every ring of the Tibetan bowl, you will remember or chant the sound of Om. Om. And just sit in this posture. Now close your eyes. Be in Pankaj Mudra, be comfortable. Think all the positive moments of your life. Go to the past and see how happy you are. Imagine what keeps you happy. Imagine things that make you happy. And you are happy now. I'm in the state of happiness. My mana sharir reflects my soul. My identity is spiritual. I'm ready to receive the blessings from universe. I bow down to the universal consciousness. Thank you. Now slowly open your eyes, and while you are in the Pankaj Mudra, do the Namaskar and bow down your head to the cosmos and say thank you to the cosmos. Now you can slowly rub your hands and place both the palms on top of your eyes and then slowly open your eyes. This calming meditation, this piece of meditation you can use on this full moon day to energize your body, energize your mind and energize your spirit, because Sagittarius is the ninth house and the house of Dharma. And when moon, which is the house lord of that zodiac, where Jupiter gets exalted, reaches this house of Jupiter, it's like the favorite lord of Jupiter goes in the house of Jupiter, and in Moola Nakshatra, it means you need to touch base with your roots. You need to connect with your own roots of your soul, and you need to connect to the divine cosmos from where you have originated, because we all are lifetime soul and we all are star child. I hope this will give you some positivity. I hope this will help all of you to improve spiritually and will give you peace of mind. Thank you for watching Puneet's Astrology. Do not forget to hit subscribe and like if you like this video. Do tell me how you like this video and your suggestions in the comment section below. For my consultations, you can drop me an email. The email ID is in the description box below. Connect me on Instagram, Telegram and Facebook. All the links are also in the description box below, where I will share quick bites, quick tips and something extra from which is not uploaded on YouTube. So thank you for watching and I appreciate your time. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, Namaste.